goes out to you, 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 and you. Yo, yo, come on, yo. Come on, hey.
Commandment number 7 for the open micer: how to handle deranged fans. As a comedian, you're eventually going to offend some group or person. It's unavoidable. Offstage, you will have to deal with people who don't appreciate your humor on a daily basis. There are many ways to handle the situation, but using the Rich Ramsey method is best. Here's an example. Let's say you just had a big win on stage talking about short Asian people. The next day, you are at the grocery store in Chinatown. While obtaining bread, you notice a short Asian man also obtaining bread. Folks, he isn't there by accident. Trust me, he's fucking with you. When this short Asian man senses you notice him, he will smile evilly in an attempt to make you knuckle under. You may think about your performance from the night before and start feeling guilty. Don't. Instead, handle the situation, quickly approach the short Asian man with a loud, "Hello, friend!" Chances are, he will excuse himself and walk away nervous. Problem solved. I do this all the time. It works. You can also play this another way, which is more fun. Let's say you just did a comedy routine about old people wearing Depends. The next day, you go to visit your Aunt Frida at the convalescent home and notice there's a bunch of old people around you. Trust me, friend. They're not there by accident. They're fucking with you. The first dirty look you get, act ashamed and scared. Then watch what happens. The people actually brighten up and become happy, like they just won a medal and the respect of their peers. Of the two, I prefer the second. It is possible to make people laugh while on stage and also give them a sense of accomplishment while off. Also, people who would actually try to make you knuckle under aren't good at giving direct eye contact. Trust me, they don't represent the masses. Seriously.
Happy hearty, har, har, fucking har.
Can you clear me now? No. I'm sorry. The psych's got a hold of you.